Good boy. You're okay, boy. All right, boy. There we go.
box. We don't got the key. Mister, help!
Hey, shut up.
Get out of here.
Act like you never saw this.
Hey, hey, isn't that...
Mister, I don't hardly know what to say. Thanks, I guess. You done me.
Hey, see, what kind of day am I having?
Yep.
Who goes there?
Whoa, whoa.
Careful not to work yourself to death there, Uncle.
I was thinking.
Yeah, does it pay well?
Eventually.
So, while the rest of us are busy stealing, killing, lying, fighting to try to survive, you get to think all day.
Well, it's a strange world we live in, Arthur Morgan.
Hey, you want to head into town? See if we can find anything out?
Sure. I got some errands to run.
Great. Go check the horses are ready.
You gonna take the old man into town? You take us too?
Well, what you got planned?
Nothing. We'll find something for y'all to do. We always do.
We're bored out of our minds. Been cooped up here for 2 weeks now. Karen's about ready to murder Grimshaw.
Well, can Miss Grimshaw spare you?
Can Miss Grimshaw spare you? What's happened to you, Arthur? 3 young, healthy women want you to take them a robin. You're worried about house chores. Let's go.
Fair enough. You got me. Come on in.
I can't believe we're going to see civilization. Feels like weeks since we did.
Yeah, Valentine.
Very embodiment of civilization.
You ladies are going to love it.
Okay, then. Let's go.
All right. Out through the trees here, then take a left. Yeah.
Sing us a song.
I got a girl in Fairyville. Can't be screwed because she's too damn ill. So I don't go down there no more. There's a blue horse laying outside her door. I had a girl in Valentine. Likes to drink that fancy wine. Blue and her hair was 2 feet tall. Cracking her pants, paid for it all. I had a girl in Fairyville. Can't get near her because she won't stay still.
Is one of you gonna get that fella's horse?
Oh, I got lumbago.
It's very serious.
I thought you wanted to head into town.
Yes, but this won't take long. Look at the poor fella.
Go on. He's an old man.
Come on! One of you.
Lumbago, really?
You all right there, friend?
Oh, hey, you couldn't help me get my other horse back from over there, could you?
I'd really appreciate the help. I'm worried this one here will bolt on me, too, if I leave him.
Sure, no problem.
Thanks. It's the white one over there.
Good.
Come here, you silly nag.
Go on, Arthur.
Come on now. Here you go.
You're a gentleman, sir. A gentleman.
Nah, not really. I was just trying to impress the women.
Well, anyway, thank you.
Come on, let's go.
To Valentine.
Woo!
You're turning into a regular old fairy godmother there, Arthur.
What's that supposed to mean?
It means you got a heart. A small one, perhaps, hidden deep inside, but a real one. And you have it, your pulse of old lizard.
Lizards have hearts.
Well, Arthur, I'm proud of you.
To be honest, if you lot hadn't been here, I probably would have robbed him.
Well, you did.
Oh, very funny.
This looks like a decent little town.
Other people, finally.
Look at all that snow on the mountains. Sure don't want to be back up there.
You think we should have asked Molly to come with us?
Oh, no. Miss O'Shea is far too high and mighty now for the likes of us. Or to do any real work. She's a society lady now. Okay. Take a good look around, ladies. See what we got here.
Go left here, down the main street.
Yeah, yeah.
There's always on the right.
Sure, you can pick up some bounties there, Arthur.
Heaven forbid you put your head on the line.
Yeah, that's a young man's game.
Ooh, yes. We can get up to some mischief here, all right.
Just remember, keep a low profile.
Will you remember that, though, Arthur?
Probably not.
Yeah.
So, let's park up down the end there, near the stables.
fire, just like I said. The cultural center of civilization. Man at his finest.
Uncle, what are we doing?
Well, we're gonna do what any self-respecting maniac does. Put the women to work.
With pleasure. We'll start at the saloon.
Okay, just stay out of trouble and don't get yourselves noticed.
Right, I need to get something from the stores.
Okay, well, we'll see you at the general store when you're done.
Come on, ladies. Imagine we're in Paris.
I imagine Paris and Valentine's.
So that's how you see yourself, is it? A maniac?
Well, in my youth, I used to be known as the one-shot kid.
Okay. I'm not gonna ask why.
You are a sad man, Arthur Morgan. But I know you love me.
Desperately. You're my favorite parasite. No, Ringworm's my favorite parasite. You're my second favorite parasite.
Very funny.
I lied. Ringworm, then rats with the plague, then you.
Shut up. This is the place now. Come on.
Morning.
So, what do you need?
Hell, a drop of whiskey for a start. You know, something to pass the time while we're waiting on the women.
Always thinking ahead, ain't you?
You're looking a bit tired there, Arthur. Why don't you pick up some coffee while we're here?
Full stock list in the catalog here on the counter. Whiskey's on the top shelf, nearest the door.
You not getting anything, Arthur?
I don't know. Maybe. So, you're actually buying for once? Are you feeling all right?
See this?
I don't know. What do you reckon?
Lamb or something? Okay, if you're done, I'll meet you outside. I won't be too long.
And passing through a bit of deserted country at night as to get to the docks in time for the tides in some place called Scarlet Meadows.
Yeah, I know it. Yeah, it's right out near New Hanover. Right, it's real quiet out there.
Sounds good. Where's Tilly and Karen?
I think at the hotel. They were picking up some drunken fellas that they was gonna rob.
Why?
Seemed easy. They have been gone for quite a while.
I guess I'll go see if there's any trouble.
There's Tilly over there. That does not look ideal.
Excuse me.
Get your hands off me.
You thought I wouldn't find you, Tilly?
You can go kiss a damn snake for all I care. Get off me. Get off of me.
I've been looking too long. I got you now. You're coming with me.
Get off of me!
Get your hands off her, friend.
Who are you?
A friend of mine.
Get off her.
Or what exactly?
You want to find out?
You're making a big mistake, Tilly Jackson.
Just get lost.
I ain't doing this with you.
Go right wait now. With Uncle and Mary Beth. They're across the street.
Okay. Thanks, Arthur.
Uncle! Look after her. I'm gonna go see about Karen in the hotel.
Sir?
I'm trying to help people. I do all I can manage. Are you doing all you can?
I'm looking for a girl who came in here earlier with a drunk fella. Mid-20s, blonde. You'd remember her.
Yeah, they're in 2B upstairs. Are you, a friend of his?
A friend of hers.
Like I said, as far as I know, they're in 2B. Trouble now, please.
Friend of hers.
Get out of here, buddy. I paid.
Ain't paid a hitter, you goddamn animal. Come here.
I paid for nothing. You two could spam me.
What the hell are you doing here?
Trying to play him. Not very well.
You okay?
Fine.
You sure?
Yeah. Nothing to worry about. Just men, but stupid bastard was boasting about the bank.
The bank?
Sure, I know small town banks are usually a waste of time, but this is a livestock town. There's lots of cash sometimes.
Okay. Keep investigating.
I will.
I hope, everything's okay up there.
After you. Thank you, Arthur. I don't much like being saved, but when I have to be.
I understand.
You okay?
Sure. He only punched me. Arthur punched him a lot harder.
Yeah. All right, then.
Hey, who's that guy over there looking at us?
Weren't you in Blackwater a few weeks back?
Me? No, sir. Ain't from there.
Oh, you were. Well, I definitely saw you with a bunch of fellers.
Me? No. Impossible. Listen, buddy. Come here for a minute.
I saw you.
Come here.
Come on, get.
I don't like this.
Me neither. Go get the girls home. I'm gonna go have a word with our friend.
Be careful, Arthur.
Just a word. Yeah! Just ballin' it.
You stay away from me!
Get back here, right now!
Oh, no!
Mister, please! I'm sorry!
You stop right here!
Come on! Get
Why are you telling lies about me?
No, no. I got it wrong, partner. I got it very wrong. Now, please help me up.
I ain't never been in Blackwater.
Then why are you chasing me?
I've got an unfortunate face.
Yes, yes, me too. Now, please, pull me up. Please. I can't hold on much longer.
All right, come on. You okay, partner?
No. No, I am not. I'm a mess.
Well, you ain't dead.
Here is that. Jimmy Brooks.
I think it's best for both of us if we pretend this never happened.
Well, I agree. You saved my life. You're a good man, and I, here. You want a pen? It's one of them ones.
Oh. That's very kind of you. But I'm not a good man, Jimmy Brooks. Not usually. You see, I was in Blackwater. I kill people. And maybe I should have killed you. Should I have killed you? Jimmy Brooks.
Me? I never saw you. Not now, not never. I think we have an understanding.
Of course we do. Jimmy Brooks. I will remember that. I've got a good memory.
I haven't. I haven't. Not one lick. Not one cent in this here old mind. Come on. Come on. You have a nice day now, sir. Yeah.
Yep.
Howdy.
You own the place.
Howdy.
But the O'Driscolls.
Hello. Good to see you.
Hey, out of the way.
Damn flies. Hey, you! Where's my horse? You said you were borrowing it.
It'll find its way back.
You bastard!
Calm down, will you?
Watch where you're going.
Hello there.
Thanks for your assistance.
Hello, mister.
On in.
Now, let me just look in here.
Enjoy.
I think I had enough. Yep.
I get all kinds of coots come in here. That's something. Saw Morris from the auction yard leaving the hotel again this morning. Guess his wife kicked him out again.
That's it for now. Thank you. Really.
Come on, Charles.
Hey, all right, there we go. Oh, Arthur, Arthur, come here, come here. Come over here, I want you to meet our friends.
Pleased to meet you.
Well, ain't you just a tough-as-teak mountain man?
Oh, you be quiet, Anastasia. Anyone can tell this one is a pussy cat.
Exactly. Yes, he's a pussy cat. Ain't that so, Arthur?
Whatever you say. How much you cost, anyway?
Well, ain't that a nice way to talk to a lady?
Oh, I didn't know I was talking to a lady.
Excuse me.
Well, I must say, you got a fine way with the women, amigo.
Yeah, regular dandy and a charmer. Where's Bill?
Oh, man. I dread to think about it.
Hey, hey, hey!
There he is!
Watch where you're going!
Take it easy,
pal! Are about to kiss that guy
a
bunch
of...
Oh, and we have our answer!
Come here, you! Shoot these bastards!
Oh, come on! We can handle these fools!
Come, sir. You won the fight already. Surely that's enough.
What business is it of yours?
No business. No business, sir, but please, I beg you.
Making new friends again, I see, Arthur.
Look who we found sniffing about.
Josiah Trelawney.
The very same.
Well, I thought you'd gone to New York.
And miss all this glamour. You must be joking.
How are you?
Well, quite well indeed. I went to Blackwater looking for you gentlemen. You're not very popular there, it seems. Ah! Javier and Charles, I've missed you. And Bill, looking as well as can be. Gentlemen, always a pleasure.
You're right. We ain't too popular in Blackwater.
We left a lot of money there.
And young Sean, it seems.
Sean, you found him?
Yes, I have. He's being held by some bounty hunters, trying to see how much money the government will pay them. I know he's in Blackwater, but there's talk of them moving.
Well, if we step foot in Blackwater... Well, then we're dead men for sure.
There'll be Pinkertons all over the place, but if he's alive, we gotta try.
Yeah, of course.
It's you they want, Dutch.
Always is. Charles, go find out what you can, carefully. Josiah, take Javier. Arthur, go get yourself cleaned up. Join them when you're ready.
Well, what about me?
Well, exactly. What about you?
What does that mean?
Oh, Bill, come on.
Oh my.
Chris!
Good God!
Lawman, couple counties over.
See his gun so loud it cracks a shot like lightning.
You lie!
My back's killing me. God damn!
cases of consumption just last week.
What in the world is happening to this place?
Come on! Give a fella a nickel! Give me a dime! Give me something!
I ain't going to sleep if this keeps up.
I just want to get a drink. I'm parched. Give a fella a nickel. Ain't nobody got a heart.
Come on, sir. Try to remember. What really happened at Sylvia's Saloon back in 76?
Just a lot of bunk, Plato. It's just a lot of bunk.
It's not bunk, Mr. Calloway, sir. It's history.
Ancient history. Done and dusted. The dead got off lucky. The living got to keep suffering. Same as always.
But did you shoot the Newton twins?
I don't give a pig's penis about the Newton twins. One of them was a girl, anyhow.
But you had been friends back in 73. You rode the Alabaster Trail together.
Funny thing about pigs' penises. They're curly, like their tails. Put that in your fucking book, Plato.
This isn't going very well.
Apparently not.
This is Jim Boy Calloway. The Jim Boy Calloway.
Who?
The gunslinger. Fastest left-handed draw that ever drew breath. He once killed 14 men in a fight at Lucy Hollow.
What are you waiting for?
How do you mean?
Well, I reckon right now, kill him yourself.
I don't want to kill him. I want to deify him. He's a god. I'm trying to write his biography.
How's that going?
I think I prefer the duel. Either I'd kill him and be able to be Baltimore's finest ever gunslinger, or he'd kill me and I could be set free from ever having to speak to him again.
Well, you're starting to understand something very important.
What's that?
The joys of gunslinging. It's win-win, freedom or glory.
That's brilliant. I'm gonna write that down, if I may.
Be my guest.
What's your name?
I don't have a name.
But you are a gunslinger.
Not really. I mean, folks who need shooting, I try and shoot in the back. All that other stuff, it's, well, bunk.
But you fought duels.
Once upon a time, I may have.
And you ain't interested in fame?
I don't think so.
Strange. But you like fortune.
I need money, sure.
Okay, then forgive me, mister, if I seem a little desperate. I am a little desperate. This book, I've got to make a thing of it, and, well, there's a whole list of gunfighters. Legends, every last one. Emmett Granger. Flacco Hernandez. Billy Midnight. Black Bell.
Never heard of them.
Maybe you can go and speak to them. Ask them about Calloway. Any of them get uppity, shoot them. I can't believe I just said that, but...
You want me to go and find some sad, deluded fools like him, ask if he was the greatest, and then if they get uppity, shoot him?
Does sound a lot worse than it did in my head.
How much you paying?
Well, a lot. Half the proceeds of the book, if you help me get it written.
I'll see what I can do.
Ha! Oh, get photos.
Okay.
And there are notes on the back of those portraits that should lead you to him.
I'll see what I can find out.
I imagine we'll be stuck here upon your return. Here are some other flop house.
Yeah. Hi. Chatterbox son of a bitch kept pestering me while I... tank.
Hello?
So I knocked his teeth out.
Was that before?
Hello?
Hey there.
I swear, I ain't recognize no one around here no more. Interlopers, the all of them. Nice evening.
Have a nice evening.
Move it, before I move you myself.
Howdy, partner. First time? Gum, candies, tobacco, all the good stuff are on the shelves behind my counter. Tonics and medicines are on the table over there. Everything else, you should see the catalog.
Let's just see what you got.
Surprised those ain't sold out yet. Usually go quick. Okay.
And that should be good.
Hey, give me some room, will you?
You goddamn idiot.
Forgive me, officer. Hey, mister.
Yeah.
Hello, mister.
Get your news here, Valentine.
Just more of the same around here. Mean men and dead bodies.
Get your paper.
Sorry to hear that. I won't pry.
Hey, boy.
Looks like you got a case of worms.
You okay, boy?
A living legend right here.
You know Black Eyed Sarah?
Yeah, you got the clap, dude.
Damn horse kicked me off again, so I killed it.
Well, I'll be dreaded.
Hello, here for a ticket to the show?
What show's on right now?
We are showing The Bear today. Come on, step right up.
Ticket for one, please.
We'll be starting soon, just inside the tent there.
Tell you a morality tale from when our country was young that the settlers used to tell about the woods of Massachusetts and the creatures that lived there. One summer, a bear was by the stream, and Old Man Wind appeared and said, "Bear, I shall blow a mighty cold upon the land. Engorge yourself on fish and meat and go find a den. Then sleep, not for one night, but for 60. Go tell all the animals of the forest what I have told you." Bear was sad because the fish were his friends, and now he had to eat them. But he knew to do whatever the wind told him. The animals of the forest often teased Bear and said he was slow and lazy and foolish for listening to Old Man Wind. "You're talking to the wind again, eh?" laughed the rabbit. "I think Bear has finally taken leave of his senses," said the turtle. "And he's getting so rotund that even I could outrun him." "I'm smart and quick," said Rabbit. "I'll outrun Old Man Wind if he comes a-calling, or you, since you're into eating your friends." The turtle said, "If Wind comes, I'll just hide in my shell." Then Bear went and warned Coyote and Possum that they should prepare for a long, cold winter. "It's so hot," said the coyote. "There's plenty of time." The lazy possum said, "Well, there's an abundance of food. Maybe I'll just store some in my pouch." Even his squirrel friends made fun of Bear. They laughed and laughed and squibbled and squabbled. "Chunky needs a nap. Fatty Goody Two Shoes does what he's told." Bear was very sad. But he was a good bear, and he always did what Old Man Wind told him. He went and found a den, snuggled inside, and fell fast asleep. Bear snored and snored for many days. When he woke up, he saw spring had come. He was very hungry, so he walked outside. As the snow melted, he saw all his friends who hadn't listened, frozen and just ready to be eaten. And that's why the bear hibernates. So listen to your elders and do just what you're told.
So long.
Damn horse.
clever,
no,
huh?
No.
Huh? With your goddamn games.
Please.
I got an idea.
No,
wanna hear it?
Hey,
huh?
You leave her be.
I ain't afraid to get blood on my hands.
Where's that horse gone to?
Assume you're finished.
Morning!
Hold up.
There's nothing to make.
Not again. Never comes when I need.
lost.
That horse don't listen. Damn. Never comes when I need it. Thank you.
You're all right, girl. Yeah, good girl. Let's move. Yeah. Okay, then.
Doing just fine out here. So how about you leave me be?
Just be wandering around here, friend.
Thank you.
okay?
Pretty good hunt there, boy.
You're okay, boy. Here you go, boy. You're all right, boy. Okay, boy. Let's go.
Dragged in.
Everything all right?
Sure.
Just get this off you. That is a good size. Well done. Mm-hmm.
gaita.
Hey, Arthur, what you want?
You know, these hides and furs can also be done up into coats and boots and such. Beyond my skills, but there's a trapper that travels around these parts, Canadian feller. Skill Tanner. He can make just about anything. You should drop in on him sometime. Thank you, Arthur.
Yeah, I know. Thanks, Pearson.
Okay, Mr. Morgan.
I wish you'd wash off that damn blood.
Hi, folks.
Hey.
Is the boy behaving himself?
I guess.
So you like the new camp, Jack?
Sure. It's fine.
It'll do us for now.
My arms is gonna fall off.
What do you think of this place, Susan?
An improvement on the last, that's for sure.
Well, that ain't too hard. Okay, I'll catch you later then.
Okay.
Good morning, Arthur. So, a feller in town recognized me from Blackwater.
That's not good.
It's okay, though. I dealt with it.
What's wrong? Thought you'd be happy to be off that mountain.
Oh, I don't know.
You ain't been yourself for a while. All right, well, I should be getting on.
Okay.